former Formula One reserve driver Maria de Villota has been found dead in a hotel room in Seville, it's been reported today. No cause of death has yet been released for the 33-year-old Spaniard. She lost her right eye in a crash last year while testing for the Marussia team. Lara Platman is a motor journalist from Blockley who's been researching the history of women in sport.
I'm terribly sad to hear this news. It's exactly a year after she came out after her accident from Duckford Aerodrome when she was testing a car and damaged her eye.
Yes, in fact she lost her right eye in that crash last year. She was hoping to get back into driving. How big was she?
Well, she was coming up through... She'd been racing for so many years. Her father, of course, was a racing driver in the 70s, so it was put in her blood, really, and she'd raced in the Euro Series 2000, Super League Formula, Spanish GT, World Touring Car Championship. So she was really coming through the ranks, and coming into Formula One was a fabulous thing for her and for women in motorsport.
Yeah, in fact, I mean, you've been working on a big project looking at the history of women in racing. Are there many women involved in racing nowadays?
Well, at this level, there's not that many. I mean, we've got Susie Wolf, of course, with Williams as a test driver there. But there's no other women actually in the driving seat, so to speak, at that level. There's lots of women in all sorts of GT championships, in all sorts of other rallies, but at Formula One, there's only a couple of women at that level in the driving seat. Of course, there's race principals and engineers, but in the driving seat, there was only a couple of women.
The interesting thing, I suppose, is that, you know, in the past, certainly in the 70s, when Maria's father was in there, you think of women and motor racing, and still to a point, it's still the case, that they're normally draped around the vehicles or you know, or passing the wreath over somebody's head when they win. It's all about the look rather than actually being a part of the actual event.
That was definitely the case. It was probably before the war that a lot more women were driving in sort of sports car and what was considered to be Formula One. And certainly in the sort of the 70s when her father was driving, it was definitely the grid girls, which is changing today. It was obviously changed today.
So how difficult is it then for women to be taken seriously and to get that kind of skill that they need to get into the upper echelons?
Well, I think it starts from right at the beginning. I mean, if it was in your family, you're sort of taken to the racetrack every weekend and that's part of your blood. But if it's not in your family, then which parents take their children to go-kart races? And there's usually sort of 10 men, 10 boys to one girl, or 20 boys to one girl, and then only 5 of those get through, therefore one of the women gets through, and then to get sponsorship for that one person. And then they've got to be good as well. So the stakes are low to start with, and then bringing it all the way through to getting onto the race circuit, such as GT, Championship, the World Touring Car, Endurance, and then single-seaters, Formula 3, to have women, many women in there, you've got to start from a really young age to get the stakes to be higher for women.
I mean, looking at just the actual space that you've got inside a Formula One car to sit, you think it would favour women, because I mean, it's absolutely squashed in minute space you've got to get into. So.
I know, and especially now, as they're saying about how drivers aren't allowed to get heavier. I mean, Mark Webber said something the other day about everyone's getting too heavy or something. I can't remember what the whole comment was about, but the cars previously, before, were really heavy, and today we've just got a lot more speed, a lot more downforce, a lot more G-force, rather. And the size, I think, of a woman isn't the case. I think it's just the stigma and the attitude that women have, other women have, to getting in a race car. There's lots of women that want to drive, but actually doing it is another matter.
Presumably you don't need physical strength. That's not a massive issue. This, in theory, could be an equal playing field, couldn't it, in the sport?
It can certainly be an equal playing field, and I don't know why it is an equal playing field. I think it's sort of got a bit messed up in the 70s and 80s, and it's taken a while to get back to having more women in the running for it. I mean, to have Susie Wolf as a test driver is a fabulous thing, and hopefully she can get into the seat, into the driving seat. But it's so sad that Maria has passed away, because she was such a great ambassador, a superb ambassador, and an inspiration for women everywhere.
Lara Platman and Motorsport are reacting to the news that the former Formula One reserve driver Maria de Villota has been found dead in a hotel room in Seville.